y'all, SS here. Today is August something something. I forgot. Oh well, it's Friday. It's in August. Date doesn't matter, okay, folks? What does matter is this. That matters. We're gonna cook this. Do you have any idea what this is? You already know because you saw the title of the movie. Nohow. These are my ingredients for the Sapo's shrimp stew. Not Cajun shrimp stew, more European style, okay? And I got these magnificent, gigantic Gulf shrimp from Morgan Street Seafood, where I go most of the time to get the best seafood in the coastal bend. So what we're gonna do, let me just run through all the stuff for you. We got chorizo, regular Mexican chorizo, tomatoes, wine, fish stock, fennel seed. I wanted to use regular fennel, but since the E. coli whatever problem at HEB, the little sprinklers water the vegetables, they threw everything away yesterday, so they didn't get any fennel in. So I'm using fennel seed, onion, black pepper, tomato paste, garlic in a jar, and this is a polenta. That's a staple to add to the stew to eat it when you eat it, to make it have some carbs. All right, so with all that being said, let's get started. All right, frying pan, a little bit of olive oil, the chorizos, they're in a casing. So what you're gonna do, you're gonna squeeze it out of the casing just a little bit at a time, drop it in. And there's a fly in here, don't you know? Never fails. Just drop it in like that, folks. No biggie. Woo! Some greasy stuff, too. Get whatever brand you like, don't matter. You can even get the vegetarian kind. Don't worry about it, it's okay, okay? I swear, it's okay. It really is okay. All right. Okay, got this chorizo browning up. Just chop it up into little pieces. Hit it like that. Just gonna cook it down. Cook this down until it renders off all its juice, okay? As such. Has a lot of grease. You're gonna wanna cook it. So all that, look at that grease already building up. So let me go ahead and do this, and then we'll, I got these onions prepared here, and we'll start cooking them down after we get the chorizo down. Alright? Okay, we got this cooked down pretty good. So just get it out of there, ladle it out. With a spoon that drains. Get it out like that. There we go. Just set this to the side. We're going to use it later. Excuse me. Now get you a handy dandy paper towel and soak up that fat. This is one way to do it. Soak up as much of that fat as you can. There we go. Throw that over there, don't worry about it. Now, add a little bit of olive oil. It's healthy, chorizo fat's not that healthy. Take your diced onion, put it in. Get you some fennel seeds. These are taking the place of the fennel roots. Come on. Get you, they're pretty strong, but you're gonna wanna get about, I don't know, a tablespoon. Throw them up in there. Some garlic, about a tablespoon. and a half for good measure. All right, now what you're going to do, you're going to put this down until it's translucent. Y'all know what that means. Until you can see through it. There we go. This is a real fast recipe, folks. Let me go ahead and do this and we'll be right back. Okay, folks. We've got these onions translucent. Now the secret part. It's not really a secret, but you're going to get you some tomato paste and get a spoon. I thought I had one. Here it is. Get some tomato paste. Get you about 2 big scoops and put it in there. And what that's going to do, start stirring it in with these onions. Turn up the heat a little bit. You're going to want to not quite burn it, but you're going to want this tomato paste to become a brown color. It's going to give you a beautiful sofrito kind of caramelization of the tomato and the onion. And just while you're doing this, keep an eye on it, because tomatoes will burn pretty fast. Tomato paste especially. Just get it like that. And have your vino ready to pour on there, because then we'll deglaze it. Don't be afraid to get it nice and hot and toasty. It's kind of like when you make Spanish rice and you add your tomato sauce in there. Kind of burn it a little bit. Starting to burn, you see the smoke coming up. Keep them moving, folks. That looks quite burnt. Get your wine and pour it in. Turn this up, get it nice and hot. You want to see the deglaze it. There we go. See, folks? That's called deglazing. Now take your stirring utensil and stir it around, thin it out, and get the caramelization off the bottom of the pan. And start bringing this up to a nice simmer boil. It'll start popping and making all kinds of crazy noises. This is the base to the stew. Soup, stew, whatever you want to call it. All right, beautiful. Now, throw in your chorizo back in. Ta-da. Get your fish stock. Get over there, boy. Get your fish stock. This is 4 cups now. Pour it in there. Oh, I wanted to tell you, those shrimp, they were $13 a pound, I think. I got 2 pounds. They're the gigantic ones that he had. So this is $27 worth of shrimp. I don't play around down here. You see? Texas. We don't play around down here. We do. Okay, I got this on high. Let it come to a boil. While that's happening, the tomatoes right here, just cut them in fourths. Don't worry about it. Throw them in. Those are good, nice chunks of tomato. Let that cook down, and the last step is just throwing in the shrimp and a little bit of pepper. We don't need to add salt. We can add some salt, though. We don't need to. So chorizo has salt, and so does stock. Let's hope it doesn't overflow. Here's all my shrimp. That's a lot of shrimp. I might, while I'm in between scenes, I might go to a larger kettle or a bigger pot. I might use this over here. I'm using that to boil water right now because we're in an E. coli scare. So I've been drinking that water. All right, we'll be back. Okay, I wanted to give you a view. This is what it looks like. We're in a bigger pot now, so it's the only way you can get a nice view. We're gonna cook this until the tomatoes become soft and all the way cooked. Everything else is in there, folks, except for the shrimp. The shrimp's here. We don't want to put them in right now because we want this to cook more. And we can also add in another 4 cups of stock right now. Let's do that while we're here. This is a different view for y'all. Kind of a close-up, you can see. This is just kitchen basic seafood stock. You can make your own. We do it all the time, but I didn't have any on hand. And you can add other stuff to this too. You can add fish, you can add crabs, you can add clams, anything you want, but we love shrimp. In my household, we really love shrimp. I added one more box, which is 4 cups. So we've got a total of 8 cups, and I'm gonna add the other wine too. I'm gonna add the other wine. This is just Chardonnay, little plastic bottles. I don't know how much they are each. Blah, blah, blah. Probably some crazy, doesn't tell you. Little bottles. Get 4 of them in a pack. So we'll cook that down, then when we come back, we'll add our shrimp. We'll let that cook down and then let it rest a little bit and we'll try it out. For a good half hour. Everything's come apart, cooked down. Got it on medium. Nice little simmer. Now we're gonna take these lovely shrimp right here and we're gonna drop them in. 2 at a time, why not? 2 or 3, whatever you prefer. So I just don't want to throw them in a whole bucket at a time and splash it and burn myself, so do it like this. And we're not going to boil no more. We're going to let maybe at the most a simmer, because we do not want to overcook $30 worth of shrimp. That would be bad. Just drop them in there, see? There, they're all in there. Turn it up just a little bit. Get them in there. They're gonna soak up all the goodness of this flavor, of this juice. Man, I tasted that. It tastes good, folks. Very good. There we go. So we'll let this go for maybe 10 minutes. You'll know when they're done. They're big shrimps, but they'll be done. I'm gonna bring it to a little quick boil, then bring it down to just a tiny simmer. And I'm gonna put the lid on. We don't want, the steam has energy in it. We don't wanna lose any of that good steam. So when we come back, folks, it's gonna be eating time. We'll cut us some polenta and garnish a dish up, get ready. All right. I wanted to show you also these beautiful plates I got from Home Goods, but they're says handcrafted from Spain. So I'm gonna pick one of these. I'm gonna go with this one since this is kind of like Spanish food. I'm a little ladle, but what I wanted to show you, this polenta right here, you just cut chunks of it out like this, little medallions, throw it in there like that. The bottom. Then get your plate, scoop up a bunch of shrimp. This is beautiful, folks. Get a bunch of shrimp, get some juice. Get plenty of juice. There, that's enough. And that's what we got right here. And it's still hot yet, so let's see what happens is the juice will go into the polenta, and you can just cut it like that. You get a little piece of polenta with each bite. In fact, that's not too hot, so let me just taste this. The rest is piping hot. Here we go. Oh, good. I guess I could just chop off a piece of shrimp right here. Piece of shrimp, a little bit of chorizo, Why not, folks? This is killer. So, I'm gonna call it SS Mediterranean Shrimp Soup. That's the name, folks. So, thanks for watching. Really appreciate it. And this is very, very lovely. I know it's summer and I know it's hot, but man, I was craving something like this. You know, you ever get to where you just want something like that, and this is what I wanted. Because I make gumbo all the time. I make all that Cajun food. I love it, but I wanted something different. You know, y'all get like that, I'm sure. Thanks for watching. Share this on all social medias. Give me a thumbs up. And you, give me a thumbs down. It's cool. I appreciate it. And subscribe if you're not subscribed yet. And we'll keep on trucking, folks. So until next time, hasta luego. Adios.